Well, tonight, some of the major oil marketing companies have started responding to the 8% reduction in their national petroleum levy on fuel. Guel, one of the major players in the industry, is selling a litre of diesel and petrol at 6.5 cedis, lower than the 6.13 cedis put out by other major players, that is Shell and Total. It is not clear for now whether Guel's action could force the other players to adjust their prices again. But what is the possible impact on businesses? We are joined via Zoom by President of the Ghana Hotels Association, Dr. Edward Akanyamike Jr. Thanks for your time tonight. As if COVID-19 was not enough, we started talking about a possible hike in utility tariffs, and now we are told, or not told, fuel prices have actually gone up. How is your industry reacting to this?
Well, Daryl, as usual, thanks so much for the opportunity. Well, what can I say? Like most other businesses, the hotel industry will be caught in the tax crossfire, as I call it. That started from 1st May. And even though the fuel has been rate has been decreased by those 8 pesos, it's still an increment. Don't also forget that we are also looking at the increase in the NHIL levy by 1%, and also the flat rate, which has also gone up by 1%. And then we are also looking at a possible upward adjustment in tariffs, utility tariffs, by June. Now, this affects us in all ways. And we are also having to grapple with the fact that our staff or workers will also be looking for an upward adjustment in their salaries. When you put all these things together, because there's the cost of living has obviously gone high, and so they will also be expecting an upward adjustment in their salaries. When you put all these things together, we dread the impact on our industry, more so when we are still in the woods. A lot of our hotels are doing averagely 30%. If you're lucky, you go into 40% or so. So it is not good times for us at all. And we are hoping that just as the start on the fuel increased, was it yesterday or today, and decided to reduce it, we are praying that they could look at the other areas as well, especially with the utilities coming up. So Daryl, it's not good news for us.
How significant is this reduction for you? It's an 8% reduction. But still, the fuel prices are going to go up, and it's going to affect other things. And so I just want you to paint a picture for us now that we know that it's going to go up by some 9 pesos. It also means that the price of other items like foodstuff, which you rely on to feed your patrons, would also go up automatically. Paint a picture of how your business is going to be affected by this increment.
Well, the point is that every aspect of the hotel operation relies a lot on the economic environment. We are talking about supplies from vendors. We have vendors who supply the industry with various items. So once there's some increment in the flat rate, it's going to affect us, and also the transportation, because transportation will also go high. So they are also going to increase their rates. Now, we also have indirect workers, okay, like our artisans, electricians, plumbers, and all that, who will also be affected by transportation. So they also want to increase their wages or their labor. And then also, we have our own workers who also use transportation from home to work and vice versa, who also be affected by that same transportation. Okay, so they will also would need some upward adjustment. The food staff, because some of the hotels actually go to the farm gate to purchase, some will purchase it from the supermarkets and the marketplaces. All these purchases will be affected by the same well.
That's okay. A whole chain. And not to mention the other taxes that are also kicking in. It's a tall order. But final one, a quick one. I just want to ask your thoughts also about this, the risk of another wave of COVID-19, as we have seen in other countries. There are other people who are suggesting that we, ban travel for countries like India. We know what that means for the hospitality industry if we have to deal with another wave. Is it something that your industry fears?
Well, Daryl, you know, in the heat of the pandemic, we made it very clear that we should be cautiously optimistic about this whole thing of getting out of the pandemic in the short term. Mm. Okay, we made it very clear because it was obvious at that time that until there's a clear cure for the virus, we cannot talk about a safe environment for the tourism and hospitality, which includes the hotels. And it's obvious that that's exactly what is going on. So as we speak now, we cannot speak confidently. Look at what is happening, even with our vaccines in Ghana. If it had gone according to plan, then we could talk about the domestic tourism, which we are all praying and hoping that it will catch on, as the minister indicated in his bulletin. But even that has a challenge. And if we also used to rely a lot on the international visits, which has been seriously affected. Mm-hmm. So Daryl, as we speak, the initial projection that we made that this thing will affect us for 3, 4, 5 years still stands, because we are not out of the woods, and we should be very clear in our minds, nothing indicates that this thing is over. It is not. So any financial projection, any fiscal projection based on the fact that, the system will improve and the hotels will begin to perform, it's a non-starter.
Mm.
That whole idea of supporting the industry still stands, because as we speak, we have not received any substantial support from government or from any quarters to survive the situation.
And I wasn't going to ask you about the stimulus package, because I know there has not been any progress made. We've been talking about it for a very long time. But as you point out, there are still challenging days ahead. Dr. Edward Akanyamike Jr., thanks so much for your time tonight. Ghana is taking steps to tap into the about $1 trillion global fund and support for environmentally friendly projects in the country. To this end.